In this video, I will show you how to work with the 3D pen garment tool. So I have opened file number 10, but you can work on any file you like. So we're going to come first to the 3D window and we're going to take a look at the two tools that we're going to use. They're here. One of them is called 3D pen garment and the other one is edit 3D pen garment. So there's also 3D pen for avatar, but right now we're using the 3D pen garment and edit 3D pen garment. So I've chosen a couple of garments that are plain. There's nothing on them, so it's easy to apply new lines. And with this tool, 3D pen garment, we can create any kind of lines that will do a variety of things for us. They can become the base for a new pattern pieces, so we can edit and create new patterns. We can cut and sew along the lines that we create. Those can be markings. They can also become top stitching. They can become some kind of a guideline for a graphic or application of trim or anything you like. So begin with drawing the lines. So again, I have the 3D pen garment tool in my hand, and you can see that you have a little dot in your hand. So I'm going to zoom in a little bit so we can see. And I'm also going to make this window a little bit larger. And I'm also going to zoom in on the 2D window on the particular pattern piece for reference, so we can see what happens when I start drawing with the 3D pen garment. So you draw simply by left clicking wherever you like. I'm going to start from the edge of the neckline, left click once to start, and then continue clicking so you can create the lines. So if you left click, you will be creating straight lines. If you hold shift, that will make perfectly straight lines. If you hold command when you click, it will create a curve point. So now the next, you can click command and release. So now you see that this point became a curved point until you click on the next place. So next time I click, I have a regular point. And here I'm gonna come to the end of the pattern. When you finish with the pattern, it doesn't matter if it's a closed shape or not. If it's a closed shape, you will just come and left click on the first point and that will close the shape. So now we have a complete shape. If that is not the point, but that is not your complete shape, so I'm going to start from the beginning. Left click, left click, left click. Hold command on a Mac or control on a PC. Left click, and then that again creates a curved point. So this time I'm going to finish, but not in an enclosed shape. When you want to finish your line, I'm going to come to the edge here, simply left double click. And now it ends the line that I like. Now you can see that I have a highlighted yellow line here, and I can see the outline here on the 2D window. Now this is simply a marking. This is not any kind of a line yet. It's not an internal line. It simply shows us what we have drawn here. Now you can come and edit this line as you like with the 3D edit. 3D pen garment tool. Left click on that. And now you can come in and select particular points. So I'm going to left click on the background so this gets deselected. So now I can come to individual points, grab them and move them if I like. So if I don't like that position, I'm going to go back for a second. So for example, this curve point, I want to have a different curve. I can grab that point and move until I'm satisfied with my curve. You can also right click on any of the points and delete them. So that changed my line here. You can also come to any section of the segments that we have created or the lines that we've created, right click on it, and we have a drop down menu that gives us the opportunity to add point, add a curve point, or trace as internal shape or convert to internal shape. So we'll work with these two in a second. But first, let's explore these two. Add point simply adds a point exactly where you clicked. So let's do it again. It's yellow, so it's hard to see. So I'm gonna clicked on the background so you can see better. So I'm gonna come, let's say I wanna add a point exactly here. Right click and add a point. So that just added a point that now we can grab this point and we can move it and change the shape that we want. You could also come to any section of the line that you drew, right click and add a curve point. The curve point obviously will create a curved section. So now we could do this, for example, that, and add curve point here, and curve the lines that we created. So that also changed. And you can see how the line here changed in the 2D window. When you finish with your line, then you can convert this into a shape. But before we do that, I also want to show you that you could also intersect the shapes, and that will create separate pattern pieces. So for example, I can create something like that. Hold the command, intersect the shapes, and finish however, wherever you like. So here right now I'm working only in the one right section of the garment. Let's say I'm finished, I'm gonna left double click, and I intentionally ended at the center frame here and I started at the neckline here so that this is only on this particular pattern piece. Now when I come to edit pattern, I can select, so I'm gonna left click on the background so that I have the full lines here. And it shows you red dots here on the pattern pieces or the pattern lines or the lines that are intersected. But you can see on the 2D pattern, these are simply markings right now. They're not any kind of internal lines or anything that we can even click on. So in order to create internal shapes, internal lines that we can edit, cut, sew, or do whatever you like, we need to come to the edit 3D pen tool, left click on that to select it. And now let's say that I want to have this particular line or marking turned into a internal line. So I'm selecting all of the sections for this. I'm going to right click on it. And I have two options here. One of them is trace as internal shape. The other one is convert to internal shape. Trace as internal shape leaves the pen mark. It stays on the garment itself as a marking or a drawing, and it also creates an internal shape. So when we create the internal shape, we could come and grab this, and you will see that you still have the marking there. Let's say, for example, that yes, you want to move or edit or create something else with this particular internal line, but you want to remember what was the original line, or you want to use that for some kind of a marking to place trim or top stitching or anything else, you can do that. So let's delete that right now. The other option that we have is, I'm going to left click to select all of these lines again. I'm holding the shift. The other option that we have is convert to internal shape. Convert to internal shape takes this line and converts the line into an internal shape or internal line. And there is no marking left behind. You can see that there is nothing left behind. This is now our internal line. And if I wanted to, I could come to it and I can cut it, I can cut and sew, I can fold and fold, do whatever I like as any other internal line. So these are the options that we have for the 3D edit tool. Another thing that I want to mention is that when we select any of these lines, so let me just grab the other line. Right now we're just working on the right side of the garment. So we can also create this line on the other side as a symmetric pattern. For that purpose, we need to grab our two pattern pieces and we want to make sure that they're linked with symmetric editing. So that's how you would place it on the other side. With the edit 3D pen garment, we could also select the full line. So I'm holding shift and clicking on all of the segments to select this full line. You can also right click on it and create a cut. So you can already cut the pattern, or you can also cut and sew. So if you just cut the pattern, you can see, give it a second to synchronize. You can see that in the 2D window, it's separated. It cut the two patterns. You could also choose, I'm going to go back a couple of steps. You could also right click on it and choose cut and sew. And you can see that in the 3D window, so let me just grab it with this line, you can see that it cut the pattern and it also added the sewing lines. So you can utilize this if you wanted to place different type of textiles, textures, different colors, anything that you want to maintain the integrity of the fabric, the garment. It is still the same exact shape, but you simply want to attach or apply, assign different textiles, or just give it different colors. So that was 3D Pen Garment and Edit 3D Pen Garment.